15 and a half. Vlog 15 and a half. What is that? Well, this is the technical broadcast. This is camera 2 of our vlog on how to use the YouTube camera select feature, which is a little known feature on how to use multiple cameras in a single YouTube video. Well, it's multiple YouTube videos. We're gonna get into all the technical specifications on how to use this on the YouTube backend. Thank you for tuning in to this technical broadcast. This is camera 2. On the below right here, you should see a camera switch button. That's really great because you can switch between our normal camera and our second camera, as you can see in this little video here. So without further ado, I'd like to transfer you over to our technical broadcast. Video, we're going to show you the back end of YouTube and how to use this switch camera feature that's kind of hidden in YouTube, but it's a really cool feature. There's two ways to live stream. You can stream now, or you can use your events. And just a little tip here, the stream now button here, you want to be a little careful with this because this stream key down here, you don't want anyone else to ever get that or else they can stream to your channel. But you can see it's offline. As far as I know, there is no way to just stream with the live feature and get additional cameras. You must go to the events tab and create an event. So I'm going to go create a new live event. And PTZ Optics, we'll just say testing. Well, we'll do PTZ Optics multiple. Let's do the switch camera feature in YouTube. The little known switch camera feature. So we'll save that. And we'll click create event. Now what we need to do, so once that event is created, just let it create for a second there. You would give it a thumbnail, which is really important because what we'll show in a minute here is the actual thumbnails that get displayed so that people know which camera they want to switch to. What I'm going to do here is I'm going to hit add camera. It's forcing me to do, okay. So I would definitely add a thumbnail there. I don't have one prepared, but this is going to be the technical broadcast. And you would select your bitrate of 1080p. And then you could stream to this address. And then once both streams are live, it will link those two videos together and they will be available for switching cameras, not only live, but also on demand, like a normal YouTube video. So I just wanted to show you guys how that works. The thumbnails are really important. The main camera is really important. One thing I've learned already is that you have to select your bitrate there. If you try to start your live stream and you have two cameras and both cameras are not streaming, the stream will not start. So if you somehow went in here and set up a third camera and you only had two streams, you have to go in and delete that third camera before you can start your live stream. So that is really the technical stuff behind this. The stream name and the stream URL, if you've never streamed before, that information goes into your streaming software. So whether it's Open Broadcast software or something along those lines, you take the URL and the stream key, and that is how you stream it to YouTube. Once you're streaming, you can then, you'll see that this will say streaming good. In fact, I guess I could stream really quickly just to show you that, and then we'll just for this. So the main camera, so that's my key there. So I'm going to go ahead and stream to that key really quickly. Start a stream to it. And I'm streaming. Now if I go into live control room, you can see there's a 1080p stream coming in. It's just going to take a second to digest it. It says health is good. You've got a little preview here. Looks like it's just so new. I gotta refresh this page here. Should come up. Oh, look, they got a new create highlights while live feature. Wow, they've got some cool stuff. But anyway, that's your stream. I have to hit the preview button, and that will allow me to preview it. It's saying here that your multi-stream is only getting one camera. And that's it. So that's the technical stuff behind this. Okay, hello everybody. In this video, we're going to show you the back end of YouTube and how to use this switch camera feature that's kind of hidden in YouTube.